Nice to meet you.
Jay Martell.
Nice to meet you, sir.
Tasha Robbins.
Come on, come on, come on. Feel that?
Emily George.
All right. Nice to meet you. Bring it in, bring it in. Started from the bottom, now we're here.
Yeah.
Come on, there he is. Boom! All right, man, good to meet you.
All right. Here we go. Right this way, sir.
What's up guys, Sal here. So today we have a legit benchmark leak of the Galaxy Note 10 of both the Snapdragon variant as well as the Exynos variant. First up, the Snapdragon 855 variant that has been benchmarked has 12 gigs of RAM and has a single core and multi-core scores of 3529 and 10840. It has a model number of SMN976V, which according to the past leaked information is the model number for the 5G variant of the Galaxy Note 10. These are pretty impressive numbers and they put the Galaxy Note 10 at the top of the Android food chain as far as Geekbench scores are concerned. As you can see, right now the S10 Plus is at the top with a score of 10,621, which is less than the leaked scores of the Galaxy Note 10. You can expect these numbers to go even higher in the final commercial release of this handset. Of course, benchmarks don't exactly represent the handset's real-life capabilities, so it's advisable to not pay too much attention to these numbers. That said, we also have a benchmark of the Exynos variant. Unlike the Snapdragon variant that has been benchmarked with 12 gigs of RAM, the Exynos has been benchmarked with 8 gigs of RAM. As you can see, it has a slightly more single core score than its Snapdragon counterpart, but failed to beat it in the multi-core department. But the interesting thing about the Exynos benchmark is the processor. As you can see, it shows the chipset as Universal Exynos 9825. The Galaxy S10 has Exynos 9820 processor. Remember a few months ago, we talked about the Galaxy Note 10 getting a new Exynos 9825 processor. It turns out it was true, which is great news for folks who are not living in the United States. Samsung left many disappointed when the Exynos 9820 was built on the 8-nanometer process, which is inferior to Snapdragon 855's 7-nanometer process. So it's good news that Samsung is stepping up its game and including a 7-nanometer Exynos processor of its own on the Note 10 and not waiting until next year. It's also worth mentioning that Samsung's 7-nanometer method is better than the TSMC one in Apple's A12 or in Snapdragon 855. But we have to wait for the actual release of the handset before jumping into the conclusion because the performance of the chipset also depends on how well they optimize it for the handset. So a couple of days ago, we talked about the charging speeds of the Galaxy Note 10, which was 45 watts. And today we have an actual leak of the charger. It has a model number EPTA845. Curiously enough, the model number ends with 45, which could be pure coincidence, but could be an indication of the charging output as well. Anyway, Samsung is finally gonna offer more charging speeds than what most of its competitors are offering. The exact charging times this 45 watt charger can produce will remain to be seen, but it will surely offer a very significant difference if you compare it to the Galaxy S10's charger. So the first Galaxy smartphone was launched in the last week of June 2009. So that means Samsung Galaxy will have its 10th birthday this month, and to celebrate, Samsung is offering free deals for people who purchase the Galaxy S10 or the Galaxy Note 9 in this month. They're offering free Galaxy Buds as well as 1 year of free YouTube Premium subscription. YouTube Premium costs $11.99 a month, so that coupled with the free Galaxy Buds is a great deal. So if you were planning to get the S10 or Note 9, now is the time. Of course, with that being said, do consider subscribing for all the coverage on the Galaxy Note 10. And as always, I'll see y'all tomorrow. Peace out.